Can anyone tell me what is genetics? So what is genetics? Tell me. Anyone?
Study of heredity and variations.
Okay, heredity. Study of heredity and variation. Okay, that's also a nice definition. See?
Study of genes.
So I hinted you. So gene. The term genetics came from gene. The study about gene, genetics. Very simple. And it is also not wrong. Heredity and variation. Gene is responsible for variation, and gene is responsible for that heredity of that variation. So anyway, gene, study of gene, how gene behaves, what is the significance of gene, study about the gene is genetics, in simple way. So the name itself suggests what is genetics. Now let's see the origin of terminology. So to origin, this gene genetics came from the Greek term called genikos, and this is called generative, that is produce, that is mean to produce. So this is generative, means that is that will produce something. For generative means produce or reproduction, it is related to reproduction. Generative means reproduction. So and reproduction, and this terminology also come from origin. So what defines the molecular physical things, molecules that define your origin, in another way, that define your origin, it's called genetics. From the, and especially it refers to a molecule, DNA, a part of DNA. It refers to very precisely a part of DNA. So in genetics we study gene, that is okay. And you are also, see, variation and heredity. So when you include all these three things, this becomes the definition of genetics. We study about gene, and gene is responsible for variation. So study of gene, study of variation, and heredity of organisms. So what will happen? Gene will transmit. Transmission of gene is called heredity. So heredity, variation, and genes, we study in genetics. What is locus, gene locus? So gene is defined by its position. Okay, any gene is defined by its position. So this is a chromatid. So what do you expect in your cell right now? Chromatid or chromosome in your normal cell, let's say hepatocytes, what do you expect in nucleus of hepatocytes, permanent cell?
Chromosomes.
You expect chromosome?
Yeah.
No, that's a wrong concept. Okay,
in chromosome there is chromatin.
Yeah, chromatid is okay. We expect happen, this chromosome is actually, if you can see, these two are very similar DNA. Aren't they similar? Same DNA, you can call it same DNA. And this DNA is produced because of what? Which process? Just tell me. Anyone? This is a duplicated DNA. These are what type of DNA? Duplicated. And this duplicated DNA are produced from replication. And replication occurs when? When does replication occur? What is replication, by the way?
When a cell divides to produce the same exact copy of itself.
The exact copy of DNA, when it is a process of DNA duplication. Okay? Replication is process of
copying DNA. Or reproducing something.
Yeah, it is related to reproduction, but see, the replication means process of DNA duplication. It is a process of DNA duplication. So this is DNA. See, and this DNA, I will teach you DNA replication. First, let me. So this is, see, DNA has two strands. So one strand and second strand. So what will happen in replication? On this one strand, there will be synthesis of this strand. So this will become one DNA. And other strand also, there will be synthesis of new strand. So this is, this way you can see this same DNA is double in size. Duplication, this is called duplication. The process is called replication. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
So DNA double. Before cell division, any cell, if it has to divide, so it has to divide into two cells. What happens? So DNA inside nucleus, that has to be doubled in amount. If it is not doubled, what will happen? So there will not be equal distribution of genetic material. And fundamental principle is to distribute genetic material equally. So this is the replication is a method to double the genetic material. And this chromosome is a doubled genetic material. If you can see, this is one DNA, compact form of DNA. DNA is very compact into chromatid. So this is one chromatid. This is second chromatid. They are basically DNA, very exact copy of DNA, like photocopy DNA. And this photocopy is formed just before replication, just before division of cell. Replication occurs just before division of cell. I will tell you in cell cycle. Did you understand this concept? In cell which are undergoing division after S phase, seed, after S phase only. And S phase is the synthetic phase of DNA. Happens only in the cell where there is probability of division. Understand this concept. So in normal cell, we have chromatid. And this chromatid, if it has to go into division, it will go into replication. And this through replication, this will be doubled. This will also be doubled. And this chromosome is before replication, before division. Formation of chromosome always there in cell which are going for division. Non-dividing permanent cell does not have chromosome. It has got chromatid only. This is a very important concept. Remember for the timing. When I talk to you about the cell cycle, then I'll explain everything there. But remember, the permanent cell have this chromatid. And the cell that has to go into division, has this chromosome. You can see the chromosome is formed because of replication of DNA. And this two chromatid is exact copy. This is photocopy of each other, exactly similar. So I told you difference between chromatid and chromosome. Chromatid is generally present in all cells, permanent cell. And chromosome will be formed only when there has to be a provision to distribute genetic material equally. So what will happen? One cell will get this part and other cell will get this part. Here will be one chromatid, here will be one chromatid. In that way, so cell division will get equal amount of genetic material. Now in general, our cell has this. So from this, gene will be, so DNA will produce RNA. And from RNA, there will be production of what? Protein. There will be production of protein. This is whole process is called central dogma. So we will talk about central dogma in next class. First today, we are talking about the genetics, introductory class of genetics. So you can see that all gene has a specific location or a particular chromosome. And this specific location is called loci, locus. All gene has a specific location. This is called locus. And this locus will define the gene. So if the same type of protein, if you produce by the gene present here, it is not same locus. So it will be a different type of gene. So locus, in order to become similar gene, locus has to be similar. You do get that? Locus? concept of locus?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Is it during replication that DNA are being formed?
Yes, during replication, before cell division, DNA are synthesized, formed. DNA duplicate. DNA is there in cell, but it will be duplicate, double in number. So this is duplicated DNA. So chromatid will change into chromosome before cell division.
Okay. During the S phase, during the replication period?
Replication happens during S phase. This is cell cycle. If you can see, this is cell cycle. There will be G1 phase. There is S phase. Okay. There will be G2 phase. And there is mitotic phase. So this synthesis, this corresponds to this phase. So here DNA, here what will happen? Cell size increases. And then here gene duplication will happen. Exact number of gene will be duplicated by DNA replication. And then this cell division will be done. And this cell has nucleus. Nucleus is chromatid. So chromatid has to be duplicated in order to get distributed into two cells. So this duplication is done by S phase through replication process. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Now, did you understand what is locus?
Yes, sir.
Locus means position, nothing but position. All gene has its own locus. So gene is defined by its position. That you have position in the chromatid. What is chromatid? In other way, what is chromatid? Just tell me. What is chromatid? What do you understand by chromatid? See, this is big strand of DNA. Okay, this is a big strand of DNA. This DNA will be folded. So I will also talk about DNA folding. This DNA will be folded many times and it will form chromatid. Okay, this is nothing a long strand of one DNA, very big strand of one DNA that is folded into chromatid. One DNA is equal to one chromatid. Did you get this? This is one chromatid is equal to one DNA, one big DNA. Just remember this. And in this DNA, here will be one gene. There will be one gene. So this is chunk of DNA will have one gene. So one long DNA will have many genes. What gene represent? Gene, one gene is equal to one protein. Generally, one gene will produce one protein. So one part of DNA will have one gene that will produce one, that will represent one protein. One part of DNA will have one gene that will represent protein. And that will be compacted in the form of this chromatid. So this chromatid, some part of chromatid will have some gene. So this way gene will be distributed among this chromatid. And position of gene will be fixed along the chromatid. Because position of gene is fixed along the DNA. That is why position of gene will be fixed along the chromatid. Because chromatid is nothing but folded DNA. Chromatid is nothing but folded DNA. It's simple. Compact form of compactly folded DNA. That's it. One DNA is equal to one chromatid. Did you understand now the whole concept?
Can you hear me?
Yes, tell me.
So we've established the fact that one chromatid is equal to one DNA, right?
Yes.
Okay. I also believe like chromatid, a chromatid is like half of a chromosome, like when you divide chromosomes into two equal halves?
Chromatid is a half of chromosome. See, chromatid, you cannot call it half of, yes, in other sense, half of chromosome in amount. Okay, in amount. But see, this is chromatid, is chromosome is exact copy of two DNA bound together.
Okay, okay.
By protein.
You already answered my question.
Yes. You did I answer your question?
Yeah.
So this is exact copy of. What is the purpose of this chromosome? To chromosome means exact copy of two DNA. So that one DNA will go into one cell and one DNA will go into other cell. That is the purpose of formation of chromosome after replication. Otherwise, if cell does not have to divide, there will not be chromosome. Chromosome appears just before division, after S phase. You didn't understand?
Yes.
Chromosome appear just before division. Just before division. G1 is a very small, G2 is a very small phase. Just before division. So here you will see at G2 phase, you will see chromosome. And the chromosome will be compacted in prophase, anaphase, after at the end of prophase. The chromosome will be in compacted form. Otherwise, chromosome are in very loose form in DNA, in inside nucleus. So understand those cell cycle nicely. I will talk about cell cycle, no problem. Just remember for the timing, this duplication occurs just before replication, just before mitosis. If mitosis or meiosis or cell division does not if there is any cell, if there is no division of cell, if cell does not have to go to cell division, there will not be chromosome. Purpose of chromosome is cell division. That's it. Now, did you understand everything? Locus, chromosome, chromatid?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So understand this concept. Now, if you understand, so see some definition. So what is gene? As I've already told you, gene is a piece of DNA that code a particular trait. Trait means a protein, particular protein. In molecular language, we can call it that will code a particular protein. Protein decide trait. This is called gene. So gene, one gene can decide color of eye. What is allele? Allele is alternative form of same gene. So see, how many of you are there? Now you have joined here. Let's say 10 people are there. Okay? 10 people are there. In this meeting right now. So see, 10 people will have, we are human, that is why, let's say chromosome number 1. So we all have same type of chromosome number 1, don't we? We will have same type of chromosome number 1. So when even if I tell you chromosome number 1, just remember chromatid. It is a chromatid. So in chromosome, we use in general term, chromosome number 1, 2, 3. Because chromosome, why we call it chromosome number? Because actually study of chromosome is done at anaphase. And there, chromatid is converted into chromosome. That is why we call it chromosome number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that way. So we are 10. So do we have all we have same type of chromosome number 1 because we are the same species, I think. Aren't we the same species? So answer, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We are same species. So we all have same type of chromosome number one. That the chromosome number one will have same length. Okay, all will have same length, and will have the same number of, actually same length of DNA also in chromatin. So what will happen? So let's see the chromosome, actually the gene at this position. So all will have similar type of gene, but not same gene. Similar, but not same gene. Because there are gene is made up of, DNA is made up of nucleotide. So there can be little bit difference among this gene. Do you agree with this? Because
yes,
we look
sir.
Different. That is why there are different slight difference in these genes. Slight differences. So these different genes which are present at same position. These all genes are called alleles. Alleles means similar genes. Similar genes with same loci. Did you get this? Alleles means, and that is why we call it alternate form of the same gene. The same gene. These are the same gene. The same genes, but they're alternate form. Now you understood this?
Yes, sir.
So color of eye, especially in Drosophila, let's say Drosophila, color of eye of Drosophila. Some will have blue color, or in our human also, some have blue color, some have brown color. So genes can be different, color for gene, but they are present on the same locus. So that is why it is called, they are called alleles. So you understand, now question comes. What is the maximum number of alleles a diploid individual can have at any time, at any given locus?
Two alleles.
Yes, we are a diploid individual, so we have two chromatin always in our permanent cell. So one chromatid from mother, maternal, one is from paternal, mother, father. So this, we one chromatid we get from mother gamete and one from father gamete. One from mother gamete means zygote, and one from spermatozoa. We all carry that. And that actually, these two will have two locus, so two alleles. We all have two alleles at the same time. One cell will have, any for any gene, one cell has two alleles. So remember, this is this concept, alleles means. So if you understand the alleles means, what is the meaning of alleles, you will understand many things. So this is the basis of actually genetics. Now, let's define phenotype. What is phenotype? So phenotype is physical expression of gene. So any gene is expressed in the form of physical appearance. Okay, all genes are expressed in physical form. So this is called phenotype. That is, the gene will express in the form of color of eye. That is phenotype. Color is of eye is phenotype. So blue eyes is phenotype. Now, genotype is, what is genotype? Genotype is genetic composition of that cell. We will separate this genotype and phenotype. How gene looks when we study at the gene. So gene type. Genotype means gene type. Phenotype means experience type. Just remember this. Easy. Locus, I have already explained you locus. What is locus? So location of gene on the chromosome is locus. Again. So now this is what is dominant allele? There is called allele. Allele is called alternative form of one gene. So many, even in people, if you see, some are dominant people and some are very recessive. So they don't dominate. So this dominant allele are allele which will dominate other when you place two allele together. So dominant allele, if this is dominant allele, the actually phenotype will be of this. This will not show its presentation as phenotype. So we will talk in Mendel's law. about this. So remember, dominant means dominating. Dominant allele and then recessive allele, which will not express when it is present. Dominant allele is present, it is not expressed. It will express only when two recessive come together. It will not be expressed in presence of dominant. This is called recessive allele. Do you understand? Dominant allele, what is allele, then dominant allele, then recessive allele?
Yes,
sir. So did you understand phenotype? What is the phenotype? Means appearance. Genotypes, gene type, locus, dominant allele, recessive allele. Dominant and recessive two alleles are the form of alleles. We classify alleles into these two forms. Now, genotype, you already, so genotype can be homozygous or heterozygous. So homozygous, two recessive can be placed together. This is called homozygous recessive. Same type of allele. If are together, they are called homozygous. Same type of allele. Same zygous. Zygous terminology came from zygote. So same gene. If they are together, it is called homozygous. And if the homozygous can be in the form of dominant. So homozygous dominant, homozygous recessive. Now heterozygous can also be of heterozygous can be only of two types, one types, because one recessive, one dominant is heterozygous. So this is heterozygous. This is homozygous, this is heterozygous. So this is called genotype. Genotype can be homozygous. Homozygous is of two types. Homozygous recessive, homozygous dominant. And then heterozygous. Heterozygous, only one type. So the genetics, father of genetics is, who is the father of genetics? You know this person?
Sir George Mendel.
Gregor Mendel.
Yes. You must have studied about this person. This is a very famous person. Actually,
he is a mathematician by profession, but he did a great work in biology.
Yeah, he actually studied physics, and physics actually mathematics and physics, they are similar. So actually he did physics, and then he became a monk, and then he did an experiment, and during his lifetime he did not get any credit for this. Everybody rejected that because he was not a scientist. So scientist community will not recognize a non-scientist people. So actually, he was not a biologist, and that is why non-biologists did not accept his experiment. But later, in the beginning of 20th century, about 1901, few scientists, Hugo de Vries and some other scientists, they started doing experiment. They found that very similar result in comparison to Mendel, and then the Mendel got the credit after he died. So you already know the history of his history, and you already know he has done experiment in the P, and he has taken about seven characteristics. He has done study on seven characteristics. So seven characteristics, he has done height of the pea plant. He did the experiment with color of flower. He did the experiment in the with the pod color and pod size. P colors and size, shape. So these all experiment, about seven experiment he did. And in seven experiment, he concluded his law into three law. So we are going to, you can say he did experiment in F1 generation. So first he actually hybridized these two, violet color, this is homozygous, violet color, and this is also homozygous, white color. Then he got a hybrid. And then again, he actually crossbred the same hybrid. And then he got result, and he named it as F2 generation. So this is F1 generation, hybrid is F1 generation. Then what he got in F2 generation. From this, he made a three analysis, and he gave a three law. So we will actually talk about that law. So he gave a three law. First law is law of dominance. Second law is law of segregation. Third law is law of independent assortment. I hope you remember all this. Don't you remember this? This three law? Name of this three law?
Yes.
You all remember this. So see, we will also talk about this law. Law of dominance, law of segregation, and law of independent assortment. What is the meaning of these laws? We will see that. So law of dominance is this law. You can see. In a heterozygote, allele which marks other is referred to as dominant. So in heterozygous condition, this is a heterozygous condition. So this is recessive, this is dominant. So this is in heterozygous condition, which the allele that masks other allele is called dominant. This is dominant allele. And the which is masked is called recessive allele. And this is a hybrid. And actually Mendel got hybrid in F1 generation. F1 generation. So from F1 generation, he actually crossbred, let's say example of this two flower. Purple colored flower and white colored flower. He expected actually, what did he expect is, he expect some flower in between the purple and white. So mixing of color he expected. But what he got was all plant had this purple flower. Now from this he concluded that there are this gene. But this trait is there in this plant. But this white trait is suppressed by purple trait. And he gave the name this purple trait because there was no discovery of in 19th century, there was no discovery of gene, nothing was developed there. People hardly knew about cell at that time. Cell was discovered, but hardly people had concept about what are there in gene, and they don't have any concept. He called it a trait. He used a term of trait, and trait later become a gene. So these two trait, he considered they are present together, but this is suppressed. This has suppressed, purple color is suppressed. So this is a dominant trait, and this is a recessive trait. He concluded like that. In heterozygous, in hybrid condition, one is dominant, the dominating is dominant. So now we know that trait as gene. So that is why we use that allele. So dominant allele and recessive allele. We use dominant allele and recessive allele. So this is the law of dominance. So not all gene, when they come together, they actually do a sort of coexistent type of thing. Some allele are dominant, some are recessive. So dominant will shadow the recessive. This is the law of dominance of inheritance. That does not mean if you see the phenotypically dominant personality, that does not mean inside it both allele are dominant. There can be only one dominant. So this is the law of dominant. Hybrid and dominant both will present phenotypically similar. So this is dominant. Both are dominant. If they come together, they will be dominant. There is no question about it. So, but see. But see, when there is one dominant, one recessive, when they come together, they will also become dominant. Did you understand this? This hybrid will also become dominant.
Yes, sir.
So this is the characteristic of dominant allele. whether it is present in homozygous condition or heterozygous condition, they are dominant. The trait of the dominant gene will be expressed. This is called dominant allele. It is dominant allele expressed in both heterozygous and homozygous. But recessive allele expressed only in homozygous condition, not in heterozygous condition. This is recessive, does not express in heterozygous condition. It expresses only in homozygous condition. That is the difference between heterozygous and homozygous. So this explains, like, this terminology are very important. Now, so from this we will study, we have some genetic disorder. We call it autosomal recessive disorder. There are many autosomal recessive disorder. So if you understand this, okay, autosomal recessive disorder means it will be expressed only when both genes come together. So then you can understand, okay, if the patient is diseased, that means the mother and father both have same gene, as at least as a carrier. And then on the other hand, you will also study some diseases are autosomal dominant. So this inherit, if you understand this laws, you will understand the inheritance. Now, law of segregation. Second law is law of segregation. So what does this law means? So this law means diploid organism has two chromatids, one from maternal, one from paternal. And then randomly selected allele for a trait to offspring. What does it means? Such that offspring receive one allele from each parent. So see, so a gene, we have actually 44, let's say autosomal chromosome. So 44, this gene, 44 chromosomes, they can be placed either way. Just understand this. Diploid organism passes randomly selected alleles for a trait. Randomly selected alleles for a trait to its offspring, such that offspring receives one allele from each parent. So ultimately, all children will have one from paternal, one from maternal chromosome. So first understand the physical. What is the physical basis? Physical basis is homologous disjunction. What is homologous disjunction? We'll talk about this homologous disjunction. So during meiosis, it happens during meiosis. Okay, meiosis. What will happen is two chromosomes are placed together and two chromosomes are separated. So we will start study about this. The meaning is that every individual will get one from maternal, one from paternal. That's it. Okay? Not both from maternal, not both from maternal. And this maternal paternal again will segregate. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Just understand this separation of maternal and paternal.
Yeah.
In a nutshell. Well, okay. So we will understand this through this. So you can see F1 from F1 generation. Remember, this is F1 generation hybrid is there. Hybrid you got from, let's say, RR. This is two recessive crossbred, and from crossbreeding, you got a hybrid F1 generation. From this F1 generation, what is achieved is this. So this individual allele will form a gamete, because now see, this R and R. So just don't remember this R means red. This is a representation of dominant and recessive. So this will form what? Two gamete. Agreed? because this is a paternal, these are homozygous, these are two chromosomes, homologous, like maternal chromosome and paternal. Now this will again produce two type of zygote, two type of like gamete. So did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Now this is mother, this is mother, and this is father. So what will happen is, RR, these are gamete, let's say mother gamete, and then father gamete, RR, father. So this is called Punnett square. Now what we get is RR, RR, then RR, and then RR. So this is what we get. This happens because of segregation of these two maternal paternal chromosome. And this is called law of segregation. So when formation during gametogenesis, two maternal paternal chromosomes separate, maternal paternal create separate with each other. So this is actually foundation of law of segregation. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
So during gamete formation, separate, segregate, maternal paternal. This is called law of segregation. And then after they fuse, again gamete will fuse, they will form three phenotypically similar. They are phenotypically will be similar, though it is in carrier. So 3:1 ratio will be phenotypical ratio. They are similar. Both dominant and hybrid will be similar phenotypically. But this is recessive, will be different. So three phenotypically it is 3:1, and genotypically it will be 2:1. So Mendel actually saw it. Two are conclusion based on monogene, single gene. When they have when he hybridized, considered only one gene. These two law of dominance. You can see the single gene here. But this law of independent assortment is when he considered two genes together from one chromosome. Two different traits. So one trait may be one trait is yellow color and wrinkled seed. So he took as yellow color plus round seed. And he yellow color and wrinkled seed. Sorry, purple color and wrinkled seed. So two traits are there. Yellow is dominant color here, you can see. And this yellow or like green color, let's say green color is recessive color. So two traits, one is color, he took one color plus one size. So he took two traits, and two traits are present on chromosome, similar chromosome. So actually what he told is these two traits also, two different traits, not similar traits, two different traits are also independently, they are independent of each other. They are not actually bound to each other. It is not that this color and size, same color and same size will transmit together. So he did pollination, and he found like he got this type of on he got this type of result. He got nine this type of actually the, he found independent this. He now zygote, if you get he got this type of result, and this type of result you will get when you assume zygote like this. Sorry, gamete like this. When you assume the gamete. This gamete separate from each other. You can see this gamete. Can you see YR? One gamete here, YR. Other gamete, small y and R. Small y and large R. And third gamete, you can see small. So from two genes, you can see four possible combination in gamete. So here four possible combination. Two to the four. So there is four possible combination of gamete here. And there is four possible, and that four possible combination can combine with each other in this four fours are 16 way, and this 16 way will produce this type of present and this type of phenotype 9:3:1. So from this he concluded law of independent assortments. What actually this means is these two gene are, so if you try to understand this completely, it takes time, but if you can easily understand it. These two genes are independent of each other. Gene 1 and gene 2 are independent of each other. When you see DNA, DNA has two genes. Let's say one gene, gene 1 and gene 2 together. So these two genes are independent of each other. They are not, it is not that one individual, if he gets a DNA, he will get both gene together. So this gene can go into some other place. In place of two genes, some other allele can come here. So this is the law of independent assortment. What does it say? Mendel's law of independent assortment states that genes do not influence each other. This is a paternal chromosome. Did you get this? Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
So this, see, this is gene number one. This is gene two, trait two, allele two. They are different allele. Did you understand this? Now, let's see this. This is one prime. And this is 2', okay? So if you see on the chromosome, they are both linked, okay? If you draw two gamete, what will you get here? In one gamete, from this, because they are placed together, you will imagine that they both gene will go together, one and two. Okay, here you will imagine, you will expect that both gene will go together. Don't you expect this?
Yes, sir.
But this does not happen. This does not happen. What happens is there are some gamete which have this gene, 1' and 2. There are some gamete here. One gamete can have 1 and it can have 2. You do get this now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what does it mean? These two genes and this here two genes, one prime, 2', they are independent of each other. This 1, 2, they are independent of each other. This 1 and 2, they are independent of each other. This is also independent of each other. So that is why there will be four combination. Four from this gene, there will be four possible combination of gamete. You can see here. Did you understand this nicely?
Yes, sir.
This is called law of independent assortment. So this is gene do not influence each other with regard to sorting of allele. Sorting means to go choosing which gamete it will join. So sorting of alleles into gametes. So gene do not influence each other with regard to sorting of alleles into gametes. This is the meaning of this sentence. This is the law of independent assortment. So today we studied three laws of Mendel. One law is law of dominant, that is very easy to understand. Second law of segregation, that is maternal and paternal alleles can be segregated. And then third law is law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment talk about two different alleles, two different genes. So two different genes can also does not actually are bound to each other. They are free to move. Okay? So this is actually general law of inheritance. So there are exceptions of this Mendel's law. Just if you understand these three laws, so you will understand the exception also better. So to understand these three laws, so we will understand the difference of the deviation of Mendel's law. We will see the example also in next class, and we will see the deviation of Mendel's law in further class.